ברוכים הבאים, we're here again, the show of Lecha Dodi. Today we're going to speak about Chanukah and the connection to the Malchuyot, Arba Malchuyot, and how it's connecting to the last war of Gog Umagog and Malchut Ishmael, the horrible things that we are viewing at our time. So we need to start off with the Mizmor of Chanukah. The Mizmor of Chanukah, Maoz Tzur Yeshuati. Over here, we see that when we read this Mizmor, it says over here, the Malchuyot. It starts off, Ra'ot Tzav'a Nafshi, Be'agon Kochi Kila, Chayai Miriru Bekoshi, Be'shibud Malchut Egla. This is talking about Mitzrayim. As the Mizmor continues, it says, Be'ado Agdola, Otzi Et Hasgula, Chel Paro, V'chol Zar'o, Yardu Ke'Even Bamtzula. It tells us what Paro and Mitzrayim did to Am Israel. It says over here, Chayai miriru bekoshi b'shibud malchut egla. Am Israel were enslaved in Mitzrayim. Secondly, it says, Dvir kocho evyani, v'gam sham lo shakati, banu ges v'higlani, kizarim avati, v'yen ral masachti, kimat shavarti, ketz bavel zru bavel, ketz shivim noshati. He's talking about galut bavel. What did the galut bavel do to Am Israel? The galut bavel kicked Am Israel out of their land. They conquered the land and took them out to exile. The third is Malchut Paras with Haman, Krot Komat Berosh Bikesh Agagi Ben Hamdata, which means Agagi Ben Hamdata, which is Haman Harasha. He wanted to kill and to slaughter Am Israel, to completely wipe them out from the earth. Therefore, it says over here that HaKadosh Baruch Hu saved us from him as well. And the Yevanim, which is what we're celebrating on Chanukah, what did they do? Yevanim nikbetzu alai azai b'mech ha-shemanim, parcu chomot migdalai, tim'u kol ha-shemanim, which means they took the oil, which refers and symbolizes the wisdom of the Torah, and they made it tamet, tim'u kol ha-shemanim. This is what the Greeks have done to Am Israel. And last, chasof uzro hakotshecha vekarev ketz hageula. Bear your holy arm vekarev ketz hageula and bring the end of the geula. Nekom nikmat dam avadecha, revenge the blood of your servants. Meuma reshaha, the meuma reshaha is usually referred to Edom, to Roma, which is considered Resha'ah because, as Tosfot brings down in the beginning of Avodah Zarah, Resha'ah means Chayava, as the Unkelus translated, which means they are Chayav on all the terrible things that they did to Am Yisrael, Ki Achalanu Yeshua Ve'en Ketz Limei Ra'ah. But he doesn't say over here, in the last bite over here, he doesn't say what Edom, what Rome did to Am Israel. It just says that a prayer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that he should wipe out those Romaim, those Reshaim. Chasof zro hakotshecha, karev ketz hageula, nekom nikmat dam avadecha, meuma resha. Unlike any other of the Malchuyot, of the kingdom, of the empires that we spoke before, that the Mizmor tells us what they did wrong, but it doesn't say anything about Rome, and we need to understand why. The same question we can ask on the Gemara Megillah Yud Aleph. The Gemara over there brings the pasuk lo me'astim ve'lo ge'altim lechalotam. What does it mean? The Gemara says that each one refers to a different empire. Lo me'astim bimei b'yevanim. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wasn't mo'es Am Israel in the time of the Greeks. Lo ge'altim bimei Nebuchadnezzar. Lechalotam bimei Aman, lafer briti itam bimei Parsiim. Ki ani Hashem Elokeihem bimei Gog u'Magog. It says over here, all the Malchuyot except Malchut Edom. We need to understand why Malchut Edom is not mentioned over here. And that is what we're going to try to explain today, the difference between the Malchuyot and how this refers and to the holiday of Chanukah that we are celebrating today. We need to know another pasuk that Chachamim Adoresh, and the pasuk says, "Va'aretz hayta tohu vavohu v'choshech al pnei teom." That also refers to the Malchuyot, and it says over there in the Maharal the following: "Va'aretz hayta tohu," that Malchut Bavel, that comes to tell us about what happened to us at the time of Bavel. Tohu Vavohu, what's Vavohu? Zu Malchut Madai. Choshech Muzo Malchut Yavan. Why is, by the way, considered Choshech, darkness, that's Yavan, the Greeks? Because Echshicha Enehem Shel Israel, they made our eyes dark. What does that mean? It means that they extinguished, or they tried to extinguish as much as they can, the light of the Torah. Al Pnei Teom, Zu Malchut HaResha'a, She'en La Cheker, Kemo HaTeom, which means the Malchut HaResha'a that we are dealing with right now, that's Malchut Edom, that's Malchut Rome, that is a Malchut that doesn't have an end. And we need to know the few things that we learned right now. First of all, that it's eliminated in some of the Gemarot. Secondly, that the Mizmor, Ma'oz Tzur Yeshuati, doesn't tell us what Edom did wrong to Am Israel. Thirdly, it says over here, Al Pnei Teom Zu Malchut HaResha'a She'en La Cheker Kemo Teom, just like Teom, just like when you see something that goes down hill, very, very deep, you don't see the end of it, just so is Malchut Edom. Malchut Edom is very different than other Malchuyot, and we need to understand that. In order to start, let's read a Midrash Rabbah in Vayikra, Vayikra Garaba Kaftet, and over there, the Midrash says the following, Rabbi Nachman Patach, Rabbi Nachman started, opened and said, Ata al tira avdi Yaakov, Yaakov, don't be afraid. Says the Midrash, Medaber be Yaakov, dichtiv vayachalom, vehine sulam mutzav arza. Yaakov Avinu started dreaming, and the ladder was on the ground, but it was going upward. How much? Amar Rav Shmuel Bar Nachman, Elu sarei umot haolam, melamed she'era kadosh baruch hu le'Yaakov Avinu saro shel Bavel ole 70 shleivot sulam. Yaakov Avinu saw in the dream what Hashem showed him, which is first he showed him 70 levels that Bavel are going up. Saro shel Bavel, the minister, the sar of Bavel in Shamayim, was going up 70 levels to come and symbolize how many years Am Yisrael would be in the Galut. Then, Shel Madai, he showed him 52 levels. Yavan, the Greeks, 180 levels. V'shel Edom, the last Malchut, Ole ve'eno yored. It keeps on going and going and going, going up, but it never comes down. V'otah sha'al nityare Yaakov Avinu ve'amar. Efshar she'en laze yerida, Yaakov Avinu started getting very scared. He said to Hashem, that Malchut is never going to go down? Amar le'akadosh baruch hu ata al tira avdi. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of the Yaakov. Afilu ole ve'yoshev etzli, even if Edom is going all the way up, he's going to sit by me. Misham ani morido, I'm going to take him down. Dichtiv, im takbia kanesher, even if you go high like an eagle. V'im ben kochavim simkinech, even if you put your nest between the stars, Misham Oritcha Neum Hashem, this is how it says in Ovadia Aleph. So we have over here the four Malchuyot, and we see that each Malchut was coming up a certain level, but eventually went down, and it didn't continue, it discontinued. But Malchut Edom is going up and up, but nothing brings it down until Melech HaMashiach, until HaKadosh Baruch Hu decides that it's time for it to go down, and Hashem Yitbarach himself takes that Malchut down. Just to understand that we have the Malchuyot, we don't count usually Malchut Paro or Mitzrayim as a Malchut, we start afterward, but Am Yisrael started off in Mitzrayim, then it was affected by Bavel that kicked us out of the land of Israel, afterwards it went down to Yavan and Paras Umadai, and in the end, after all that, Am Yisrael went through Malchut Edom. So we see over here that Malchut Edom again is very different than other Malchuyot because it doesn't have we don't see the end of it. It's just like Tehom, just like when you look on the bottom, when you look at something very, very deep, you don't see the end of it. So does Malchut Edom. Just like the letter that Yaakov Avinu was seeing, that Malchut Edom, the kingdom of Edom, goes up and up without end. He doesn't see it ever coming down, and it keeps on rising always to the top. And we see that it's called over here in Megillah Yud Aleph, under the psukim of lo me'astim ve lo ge'altim lechalotam, HaKadosh Baruch Hu was not mo'es Am Yisrael. He didn't get rid of Am Yisrael, although they went through Yevanim, Nebuchadnezzar. Still, HaKadosh Baruch Hu was still holding on to Am Yisrael and saving them, but for some reason, the Gemara doesn't bring Edom as something that HaKadosh Baruch Hu sees a reason why to save Am Yisrael. And we need to understand, why is it that by Malchut Edom, it doesn't say that HaKadosh Baruch Hu was not disgusted from Am Yisrael, was not trying to get rid of Am Yisrael. Lo me'astim ve'lo ge'altim, that refers to every other Malchut, but it doesn't say Edom. Why is that? If we learn what Rav Chaim Volozhiner wrote in the Drashot to Slichot, he wrote the following. He says the following lashon, Yadua שבגלות מצרים היו הללו עובדי עבודה זרה והללו עובדי עבודה זרה. When Am Yisrael were in Mitzrayim, everybody were עובד עבודה זרה. The Egyptians and Am Yisrael as well were affected and started worshiping idols as well. בגלות בבל נשאו נשים נוכריות. Am Yisrael in גלות בבל married גויות נוכריות. ואף על פי כן גאלם השם יתברך. All that we did, עבודה זרה, נשים נוכריות, but still, הקדוש ברוך הוא saved us from every גלות. אבל אנחנו, today, says Rav Chaim Volozhiner, תחת הסמך מם, אשר אנחנו בעצמנו מוסיפים לו כוח בכל עוון וחטא פרטי. The difference between every other galut and galut Edom is that in galut Edom, we are actually the ones that are feeding the galut, unlike any other galut. Any other galut that Am Yisrael went through was such a galut that was opposing Am Yisrael. And Am Yisrael were trying to fight it, trying to get rid of it, trying to get off that malchut and live freely. But when we're talking about malchut Edom, we are the one that putting gas into the car, into the vehicle of Edom, and letting it continue the way it is. ואמרו חז"ל, אין הקדוש ברוך הוא נפרע מאומה, אלא אם כן נפרע משרה תחילה. ואם כן, בגלות הזה, איך תהיה נפילת השר? Asked Rav Chaim Volozhiner. He says, how could you get rid of the שר, of the minister in the Shemayim, or the angel in the Shemayim, or מלכות Edom, when we are the one that keeps on feeding it? הלו מאחר שאנו מצדדים בידו ותומכים בידו ומגבירים אותו על עצמנו, we are the one that's giving it the strength, we are the one that can give it the length of the galut, that we don't see the end of it. So therefore, how is it possible that the galut will come to an end if not that הקדוש ברוך הוא would be מרחם on Am Yisrael? But otherwise, מצד העולם הזה, it's impossible for that galut to end. And the Maharal Miprag explains in Netzach Yisrael Perek Yud Zayin, כי כל שלושה המלכויות הראשונות ראה יעקב עלייתן וראה גם ירידתן. When יעקב אבינו looked at the galuyot, he saw that each galut will come to the highest point and eventually come down. חוץ ממלכות רביעית, except the fourth kingdom, the fourth empire of Edom, שראה עלייתה ולא ראה ירידתה. When יעקב אבינו looks at Edom, he keeps on seeing it going up, but never goes down. Why is that? Says the Maharal Miprag, וזה מפני כשאר מלכויות נותן להם השם יתברך ירידה מצד העולם הזה. אבל מלכות רביעית ירידתה מצד העולם העליון, והשם יתברך בעצמו מוריד אותה כדכתיב עם תגביע כנשר, ולא ירידתה רק על ידי מלך המשיח. Which means like this, all the other מלכויות are naturally going down. When a person runs and runs and runs and succeeds in something, there's always a certain point that's the highest point he can reach. Once he reaches that highest point, eventually it goes down. This is what happened to all the first three kingdoms. First, they were running, they were succeeding, they were very, very much elevating themselves. Many, many years, Babel 70, then 52, all this timing that they had was given from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's how long they can be a king, this is how long they can rule over the world. But eventually, when they got to the peak, HaKadosh Baruch Hu brought them down, or they came down rather, they came down naturally, because that's all the power, that's all the strength they were given. But Malchut Edom keeps on going and going, and never comes down. Why is that? Because over there, it's not mitzad ha'olam hazeh. It's mitzad ha'kadosh baruch hu that gave them strength because of Am Yisrael. Since Am Yisrael are continuously feeding that Malchut, it doesn't come down naturally because it's not fed to the naturally. It's not, so to speak, given the regular Olam Hazeh powers or nature, and therefore eventually it doesn't come down unless the Kadosh Baruch Hu himself intervenes. And that's what the Michtav Eliyahu explains. He says the following: Gimel Malchuyot yesh hagbala lekoach aliyatan. Ve'achar shehigiu el katzeh rum ha'aliyah shehugbala lahem bedivrei yemei ha'olam, when they come, all the three Malchuyot, when they reach the peak, what that was given to them naturally in this world, yardu migdulatam bederech ha'tev. Naturally, also they come down bederech ha'tev. אולם ירידתה של מלכות אדום אינה בדרך טבעית. מלכות אדום is not so. Why not? So we explained, just like we saw in Rav Chaim before, that they come to the peak only because HaKadosh Baruch Hu said and gave them that power up to then. But not more than that. When we're talking about מלכות אדום, we need to understand another point. And that is, מלכות אדום has the power because of Am Yisrael. Where did we find such a thing? When Yaakov Avinu got the brachot from Yitzchak, Yaakov Avinu was given all the wealth of this world. But when Esav came in and Esav started crying, Yitzchak told him, you know what? All the wealth that I gave Yaakov, that's on condition that they are still keeping the Torah and the mitzvot. Vayaki asher tarid. Once Am Yisrael is not keeping Torah and Mitzvot anymore, or they doing Averot, then you getting the strength, you getting the power, and everything comes to you. So Mimele, in all the other Malchuyot, when Am Yisrael is really opposed to the Malchut, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu eventually brings them down. But over here, the way it was given, the way it was programmed, is that Malchut Edom is fed from Am Yisrael. As long as Am Yisrael are doing Averot, Edom keeps on going. And we see that Yaakov Avinu looked at Edom and saw them going up and up and up and up the ladder. Why is that? Because Am Yisrael are feeding it with their Averot. When Am Yisrael doing Averot, so that's what goes into Vayak Asher Tarid, Ufarakta Ulo Me'al Tzavarecha. Edom keeps on going upward and upward. And therefore, Edom has the power from Am Yisrael. Am Yisrael gives them that drive that keeps them going and doesn't come down. And there, the Navi said there's two ways that Edom would end and Am Yisrael would start ruling again with Melech HaMashiach. One is Beito and one is Achishena. If Am Yisrael would stop that drive of Vayak Asher Tarid and start doing the right mitzvot and stop doing Averot, that is Achishena, right away, that would stop. Malchut Edom wouldn't have any more the energy to continue. But if not, then we have to wait to the end of days. That is Beita, which means the end of days, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu himself would bring Edom down. And to understand that and put everything together, we need to know how and why was HaKadosh Baruch Hu chose Am Yisrael as his servants, as his people that gonna be a light to the nations. So the way it's explained is the following. Pachad Yitzchak says that whenever a master wants to buy a slave, there's gotta be few things, probably four things, that you need in order to have the slave working for you and doing the right job. First of all, you have to have a slave in the market. There's gotta be an existence of such a thing. If we look today, a person wants to buy a slave, it doesn't exist. You don't find a slave because it doesn't exist in the market. But when there was a slave, you needed to have that slave. Secondly, after you have that slave, you need that to have the master acquiring that slave. He needs to buy it. He goes to the market, slave market, and he buys himself the slave. But the slave can't work it until you tell him what to do. You must tell him and direct him, this is what I need you to do. And then, that's not sufficient and enough, you have to give him a place of work. So let's say you want him to work at your field, so you'll do those things. First of all, you have to go to the marketplace and find that there is such a merchandise, such a slave. Secondly, after you did, you have to acquire him. Thirdly, you have to tell him, this is what I need you to do at the field. And fourth, you have to give him the field and find him a place that he could actually work. And this is what happens with all the galuyot. All the galuyot came to interrupt the work, the worship that Am Yisrael wanted to do to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Am Yisrael are avadim to Hashem Yitbarach. And all the malchuyot, all those empires, came to interrupt that work that Am Yisrael has to do. For instance, if we start with Mitzrayim, when Am Yisrael were in Egypt, they were slaves to the Egyptians. So Mimele, Am Yisrael can't be slaves to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And when HaKadosh Baruch Hu took us out of Mitzrayim, he says, "Avadai hem asher hotzeti otam me'eretz Mitzrayim." Now they are my slaves. And Chazal adoresh on this, "Avadai velo avadim la'avadim." As long as they were slaves to the Egyptians, Am Yisrael can't work HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They're not free. But once HaKadosh Baruch Hu took Am Yisrael out of Mitzrayim, what was the purpose of that? Now Hashem says, you are my slaves now. "Avadai hem asher hotzeti otam me'eretz Mitzrayim." I took them out of Mitzrayim, where they were enslaved. Now, they're not free people. Now they are my slaves. HaKadosh Baruch Hu took us out to be his slaves. So this was the galut that we were in Mitzrayim. Later on, there was a galut Bavel. What happens in galut Bavel? When Am Yisrael taken out of Mitzrayim, Hashem Yitbarach also took us and put us in Eretz Yisrael, because that is the workplace. Came Bavel and took us out. That was Bavel, Malchut Bavel. What did they do? What's the evil that they did? They took us out of Eretz Yisrael to exile. So Mimele Am Yisrael can't work HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the place of work. Like the field of Am Yisrael where they need to work and worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu is Eretz Yisrael, with Korbanot, with Beit HaMikdash, with Mitzvot. Now we were taken from our land. Later on, while in exile, there was also Malchut Paras. Malchut Paras, what did they want to do? That's Haman. He wanted to destroy Am Yisrael. He wanted to kill the slave that he wouldn't be in existence. And the Yevanim, what did they do? They wanted to confuse Am Yisrael, take away the message, the direction that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave to Am Yisrael. This is what I need you to do. There's a certain thing that the master tells the slave that he needs to do, that is the Torah Kedosha. Came the Yevanim and make Am Yisrael not be able to keep the Torah, because they darkened their eyes in the confusion that maybe you don't need to keep the Torah, maybe you need to keep some kind of other laws that the Yevanim created. So this is the Mashal and the Nimshal that we learn in that Mizmor of Maoz Tzur. So again, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to Am Yisrael to be avadim to him, he needed to do the following thing. First, he needed to create Am Yisrael as a nation for himself. Secondly, he needed to take them out of slavery in Mitzrayim, which means he acquires them as his slave. Thirdly, after that, he also tells them what he wants to do, and that is with the Torah Kedosha. He gave them the Torah, and this is what I want you to do as slaves. And fourth, he needs to give them a place of work, and that is in Eretz Yisrael. And each malchut from those malchuyot that we mentioned try to take one thing away from that, so Am Yisrael will not be able to worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Mitzrayim try to take away the avdut, which means that they will not be acquired to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, they are not going to be his slaves. Bavel tried to take away Am Yisrael from the place of work, take them out of Eretz Yisrael, so they wouldn't be able to worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Paras, which is a man, tried to completely destroy the slave that is not going to be in existence. And the Greeks, the Evanim in Chanukah, tried to take away the message, what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted Am Yisrael to do, the Torah Kedoshah, and tried to tell Am Yisrael, don't keep the Torah, and confuse them with the message. So therefore, when we come to the Mizmor of Maoz Tzur, we see that each thing is mentioned over here. The first thing that we learned is Paro. What is Paro? What did Paro do? What did Mitzrayim do? Chayai mireru bekoshi b'shibud malchut egla. They were enslaving me. Shibud. That is the problem over there. They took away the ability from Hashem to enslave Am Yisrael. Avadayim velo avadim l'avadim. Now they are avadim l'avadim. Now they are in Mitzrayim. They can worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The second thing that we found over here is Bavel. What did Bavel do? they took Am Yisrael away from the land. So that is mentioned over here. It says, Dvir kocho eviani, וגם שם לא שקעתי, בא נוגס והגלני, took me to exile, he took me out of the land of Israel. The third thing that we found is by Haman, that tried to completely destroy Am Yisrael, krot komat berosh, he completely tried to destroy the slaves so he wouldn't be able to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu, serve his master. And the fourth thing that happened is in Yavan, in Greek, that what did they do? Timu kol hashmanim, they came to make the oil impure. Oil refers and symbolizes the Torah Kedoshah, tries to say that the message of the Torah don't do what the Torah says, have a new understanding of how to do things, and that is coming to take away the message that Hashem told Am Yisrael in the Torah. But when we're talking about the very last thing, and that is Malchut Edom, it doesn't say anything that they do wrong. Why? חשוף זרוע קודשך, קרב קץ הגאולה, נקום נקמת אדם עבדיך, מאומה רשעה, כי ערכה לנו הישועה. But it doesn't say what did Edom do wrong. And the reason for that is because Edom did all of these that we mentioned before. All of the above. They, within that lengthy galut, they try to do all of what the Malchuyot previous have tried to do to Am Yisrael. First of all, they were trying to kill Am Yisrael so many times, just like Haman wanted to kill Am Yisrael, Malchut Edom tried to kill Am Yisrael with persecutions and pogroms and all kind of different things throughout history, over and over and over again. That's first of all. Secondly, Malchut Edom also kicked us out of the second Beit HaMikdash, just like Bavel did. They took us out of the land, of the place of worship. Thirdly, they always try to always darken our eyes, just like Yavan did, with a different message. HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave the Torah, don't learn the Torah, becomes Christians. Edom always refers to Christianity. So therefore become like us. They try to change us in that aspect. So we see that whatever they did over here, including what Paro tried not to enslave us, was happening throughout history over and over and over again. So therefore Edom is called Malchut HaResha'a, which means Chayava, guilty. What are they guilty? They're guilty with all of the above. All the other Malchuyot, whatever they tried to do, Edom was doing all of that and more. And that's why when we read that Gemara in Megillah says, that lo me'astim velo ge'altim lechalotam. Lo me'astim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu wasn't mo'es Am Yisrael b'imei Yevanim. Why? Because b'imei Yevanim, although Am Yisrael would try to be confused with the Torah, but Am Yisrael had so many other things going for them. They had the land, they were trying to worship in the land. So something was going wrong. HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, okay, I only tried to take away one problem from Am Yisrael, and that is the Yevanim, and Am Yisrael would return to be my nations, my slaves, my people. When we're talking about Nebuchadnezzar, lo ge'altim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, although he saw that Am Yisrael are not in the place and in the land where Am Yisrael needs to be in order to worship him, but HaKadosh Baruch Hu knew that all I need to do is bring him back. So therefore, lo ge'altim b'mei Nebuchadnezzar. 70 years later, HaKadosh Baruch Hu brings us back, and all he needs to do is bring us back to the place of work. We have everything else going. Lechalotam b'mei Haman, Am Yisrael had everything b'mei Haman, they were doing everything. They just tried to kill Am Yisrael. Kadosh Baruch Hu says, I'm not going to allow this. Leafer briti itam b'mei Parsim, and so on. But it doesn't say Edom. Why it doesn't say Edom? Because b'mei Edom, they came and they robbed us from everything. Nothing is left in b'mei Edom. In Edom, they took away the Torah. They took away the slave himself. They took us away from the place of worship. They decided to enslave us. When Edom was doing all that, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu is left with nothing to hold on to. Why should I save Am Yisrael? They're not anymore in their place. They're not anymore keeping the Torah. They even robbed out of their Torah. They're not anymore worshiping me. They're taken away always by the Romans. And who's feeding them all that? It's not that it's the Romans' complete fault. It's also Am Yisrael's fault. Because they are the one that's feeding them, as the bracha that Esav received, v'ayak asher tarid ufarakta ulo me'atzavecha. And since Am Yisrael are the ones that's consistently feeding them, HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't see where is it that I need to save Am Yisrael, if not, as the Midrash Rabbah explained, as the Maharal explained, and so many of the Mefarshim we learned before, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu himself in the time of Beita would see that it's time to completely destroy Edom and bring Am Yisrael back. If not for that chesed that HaKadosh Baruch Hu does with Am Yisrael, Am Yisrael would be completely lost. And therefore, we need to understand that although we have those four malchuyot with the Malchut Edom that constantly tries to do all of the above, as we just explained, we come into, right now, in the end of days, to something new that wasn't mentioned in any of those Midrashim or Gemarot that we said before. And that is something that is called Malchut Ishmael, Yimach Shemam. Malchut Ishmael are actually, as we have bad Edom, Malchut Ishmael could be that even worse than that. Rav Chaim Vital writes in Malchut Ishmael, Atidim Israel Yod Bacharit Hayamim Begalut Ishmael. Rav Chaim Vital already 450 years ago, 500 years ago, writes to us and tells us that you need to know that in the end of days, Am Israel under will be under Galut Ishmael. Vegalut Chamishit Zo Shiachrona Kasha Mikulam. That's harder and more tough than all the other Malchuyot previously to that. Higalut Ishmael Anikra Pere Adam. In Daniel, when we have over there the dreams of Daniel, the Chazyonot, we see over there that it says the following: Ba'et ha'i ya'amod Michael Asar HaGadol ha'omer al bnei amecha. At that time, Michael would stand on top of Am Yisrael. Ve'ayta et sara asher lo ni'ita miyot goy ad ha'et ha'i. That in Daniel, it says in the Nevuah, that at that time, in the end of days, there would be a et sara, a crisis that would never happen before since Am Yisrael became a nation. Vaita et sara asher lo ni'ita miyot goy ad ha'et ha'i. So that's David explains over there. Az tiyeh et sara shel Yisrael asher lo ni'ita lehem me'et ha'yota le'goy ad ha'et ha'i ki malchut Ishmael yatzer lahem me'od. Says in Metzudat David, that what is this referring to when Daniel tells us there's going to be such a terrible time in the end of days? That refers to Malchut Ishmael. And it says in Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer, Perek Lamed Aleph, Lama nikra shemo Ishmael? Why is he called Ishmael? Sh'atid HaKadosh Baruch Hu lishmoa bekol na'akat ha'am mima sh'atidim bnei Yisrael la'asot ba'aretz ba'acharit ha'yamim. Lefichach nikra shemo Ishmael, just like it says in Tehilim Nunhei, Ishmael Vayanem, which means the name of Ishmael, says the Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer, is because Am Yisrael would scream so much to HaKadosh Baruch Hu from the pain that they would have, from the tzarot, from the terrible time that they would go through, that they would scream so much and Hashem will hear us, Ishmael Vayanem. And that is the reason it's called Ishmael. Rav Chaim Vital says in Tehilim Kuf Kaf Dalet, that בגלות האחרונה שיגלות ישמעאל נקרא ישמעאל על שעתידים ישראל לצעוק צעקות גדולות בימי גלותו ואז ישמעאל ויענם. Same thing like פרקי אליעזר, רבי אליעזר, רב חיים ויטל, the Talmid of the Arizal tells us that the reason it's called ישמעאל is because in the last galut it's going to be so hard, so terrible, there's such פראי אדם that Am Yisrael would not know how to be able to cope with them. And the Zohar פרשת וירא says, אוי לאותו הזמן שנולד ישמעאל בעולם ונימול. אוי וי, to that time that Ishmael was born. Kadosh Baruch Hu himself says that he regrets creating Ishmael. It's a terrible thing, says the Zohar. מה עשה הקדוש ברוך הוא? What did הקדוש ברוך הוא do when he was born? הרחיק את בני ישראל, ישמעאל מדבקות העליון נתן להם חלק למטה בארץ הקדושה. Instead of being במלכות העליון, דבקות העליון, he brought them down to the land of Israel, חלק למטה בארץ הקדושה. And says the Zohar הקדוש, look at this prophecy of the Zohar. ועתידים בני ישראל לשלוט על ארץ הקדושה, זמן הרבה, ישמעאלים ימח שמם, would be the one ruling over ארץ הקדושה. והם יעקבו את בני ישראל לשוב למקומם, עד שיושלם הזכות של בני ישמעאל. There will be an interruption, and there will be me'akev, they would stop and block Am Yisrael from coming back to their land. And then the Zohar tells us what's going to be in the end of days. ועתידים בני ישמעאל לעורר מלחמות גדולות בעולם. ישמעאלים would start great wars around the world. There will be a lot of wars around the world. ויתאספו בני אדום עליהם וערכו עמהם מלחמה. אדום, which is the Christians, who come to fight בני ישמעאל. And the war would be אחת על הים, אחת על היבשה ואחת סמוך לירושלים. In the ocean, in the land, and there would be also one very close to Yerushalayim. וימשלו אלו על אלו, one would be מושל on the other, one would be ruling over another. I guess there would be different timing that different מלכויות would rule after the one over the other. It says in the Gemara in Yuma Daftet over there that there's a machloket who would rule on the end of days for 9 months. Is it the Ishmaelim or is it the Domim? There's different opinions over there. It could be that they both are right according to this Zohar. Imshelu elu al elu, one this time and one on another time. Ve'eretz ha'kdosha lo timaser levnei etom. Be'oto zman, says the Zohar HaKadosh, itorer am echad misof ha'olam al romi ha'resha'a ve'aroch aleha milchama shlosha chodashim. Which means there's a war over here between Edom and Ishmael, the Christians, I guess it's the Europeans and the Ishmaelim, and while they're fighting one with the other, and one takes over the other, there will be another nation comes from the end of the world, a different nation that will come to make a war with them. So that could be that it's referring to North Korea. באותו זמן יתעורר עם אחד מסוף העולם, it's in the end of the world. It's ממש מדויק, it's so precise, that will come up on רומי הרשעה וארוך עליה מלחמה שלושה חודשים. The world would, the war over here would take place 3 months. ויתאספו שם עמים ויפלו בידיהם עד שיאספו עליה כל בני אדום מכל קצווי העולם. And then after that war, land would make from the end of the world, that country would make, אז מתעורר הקדוש ברוך עליהם. הקדוש ברוך then arises and comes to הקדוש ברוך הוא, to עם ישראל, and what would he do? יחלט בני ישמעאל מן הארץ. He would destroy the ישמעאלים, take him away from the land, ישבר כל הכוחות שלמעלה, לא יישאר כוח למעלה על עם העולם. Nobody would be able to rule over עם ישראל when הקדוש ברוך הוא appears, אלא כוח ישראל לבדו. And that's also what it says in the Zohar, in Bereshit Kuf Yutet, it says over there, Bnei Ishmael, atidim bazman ahu leorer yachad im kol amei haolam lavo leYerushalayim. The Ishmaelim in the end of days will come together with all the nations, all the Europeans, which means we're having a fight over here. But apparently the Zohar also tells us that there's going to be a certain agreement between the Europeans and the Ishmaelim, as we're seeing today, that will come to fight against Yerushalayim. Today we're seeing this prophecy comes up. There's a land of Israel, there's a Malchut in Eretz Israel, and the Europeans, which is Edom, will come together with the Ishmaelim in order to fight Am Israel, and they would be first having wars one with the other, and then a land from the end of the world would come to fight with them. Now, it says over here, ואספתי את כל הגויים אל ירושלים למלחמה. That's what it says in the Zohar, that all these nations will come to Yerushalayim to fight a war. And the Ramak, which lived already about 450 years ago, says, הזדמנו כל הממיה ויעשו הצד שלום ביניהם והתהפכו על ישראל להשמיד. All of these nations will come up together in order to destroy עם ישראל. מפני שקימו להם מלכות, says the Radak, because עם ישראל made a land and made over there a country, a מלכות. אמנם לא יבואו לשבר אלא ממנה היוושע. In the end of the days, the הקדוש ברוך הוא would save עם ישראל from the ישמעאלים. So we need to understand and know, we explained before, that there are מלכויות that's coming to interrupt עם ישראל from worshiping הקדוש ברוך הוא, which is the reason why עם ישראל were created, which is the reason why הקדוש ברוך הוא created the whole world. The whole world purpose is in order to honor HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and Am Yisrael is in order to be light for the nations, that they should direct the nations to see what is the purpose in this world. But what is Ishmael coming to do over here? Why, first of all, Malchut Ishmael is not mentioned in any of the Gemarot and Midrashim as part of the Malchut that should be the one that would be a fifth Malchut, or one of the four Malchuyot, That is a question that the Maharal is asking, and he says this brilliant answer. It says like this. It's brought down in Sefer Mimamakim. From the Maharal, he says like this. Madu Ishmael lo nimna bedalen malchuyot shera'a Daniel. Why Ishmael is not mentioned in the malchuyot that Ishmael saw? Ishmael, that Daniel was given the nevuah. Nebuchadnezzar saw a dream, and in the dream he saw a big structure like this with the head made out of gold, and then the chest was made out of silver, the stomach was made out of copper, and the lower legs were made out of iron and earthenware. And then he saw that a stone was thrown to it and everything collapsed. But and the explanation to that, he says over there, Daniel, is that the head comes to refer to the first malchut, then second malchut, third malchut, and fourth malchut, that each one would take place one after the other. But in the end, when you throw the stone, that is when Mashiach will come, Am Yisrael will take over just by a small stone, that everything will be destroyed. So why is it that Malchut Ishmael is not mentioned as one of the Malchuyot? It should be an extra piece for Malchut Ishmael, that would be the Malchut Revit. Says the Maharal, Ki Malchut Ishmael kivyachol losif Malchut Shamayim. Ishmael look like they're trying to be doing Kiddush Hashem, to be Mosif Kvod Shamayim to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, try to honor HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is how it looks like. They're doing everything L'Shem Shamayim. They're willing to sacrifice themselves, kill themselves, do all their, everything that they do throughout the day. It seems like they're very religious. Osim HaKol B'Shem Hashem. Everything they do is for the purpose of Hashem. Ela Shebeyot Meot Ishmael Pere Adam Ishmael is called in the Torah Pere Adam. So therefore, because of that, הרי שאמונתם בהשם גורמת לעשות את כל הרע שבעולם, which means they take their belief and they use it actually in a negative way. You would think that a person that's a believer like them, very, very much religious, very haduk, completely keeps all the laws, you would think they would behave the way they should. Instead of that, they take in their belief and they're using it for a negative. It's to do all the rasha ba'olam. And they're just using that with a cover-up that it's in order to do it for Hashem Yitbarach. But really, it's the evil in the highest form. Elachen, says the Maharal, it wasn't mentioned within the four malchuyot. Because the four malchuyot, the four kingdoms that we explained, each malchut actually came to oppose Am Yisrael and to block them and to interrupt them in Avodat Hashem, because those malchuyot didn't want Malchut Shamayim, didn't want to honor HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And therefore, since they saw Am Yisrael that are the ones that symbolizing the Avodah to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so each one came to interrupt that Avodah. The Malchut of Paro took away the slave in order that Am Yisrael should not worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Then later on we found Babel took us out of the land of Eretz Israel so they wouldn't be able to worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the land of Israel. Then, as we explained, Haman and later on also the other Malchuyot that constantly, the Malchut Yavan that we're talking about in Chanukah, that tried to take away the most important thing, that's the Torah. But that is in order to oppose HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But Ishmael, it seems like it's a cover-up that they're coming as in the name of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They're now coming to honor HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So therefore, since that is the purpose of Ishmael, they can't be counted as one of the four Malchuyot, because the four Malchuyot only come to oppose Hashem Yitbarach. So therefore, they're coming in the name of Hashem, B'Shem Hashem, but they're doing all the evil. That's why it's so, so terrible, and Ishmael is considered to be the worst of all, as we learned before, and we said that Malchut HaChamishit, as Rav Chaim Vital explains, would be Malchut HaChamishit Shiachrona Kasha Mikulam, that would be the harder of all. So what is Chanukah coming to teach us? When we're talking about Chanukah, we're coming to say that there were Rabim Beyad Me'atim. If a person believes in Hashem, if a person does the right thing, he could be only very numerous. Just like the Chashmonaim, Rashi says that the Chashmonaim were 13 people against the empire. How did that happen? That is the nevuah in the last of Daniel, which means one little stone will come to that huge structure that we have over there, the Pesel, that Nebuchadnezzar saw in his dream. And that little stone will come out and kick that structure and everything would collapse. And that is what happened in Hanukkah. This is the message of hope that we have right now, that we know that we're keeping on the last galut, that's harder of all. In one hand, it's a dome that has all of the above, as we explained before. And it's mentioned very nicely in that Maoz Tur, that it says over here, Chasof Zroa Kochecha, Karev Ketze Yeshua. When we're learning those words, really we can refer that although in the Malchut Edom that's mentioned in the last section of Maoz Tur is not mentioned what they did wrong, but each thing of Malchut Edom, as we explained before, has all of the above, and it's mentioned and it's hinted over here. Chasof Zroa Kochecha came to deal with Kochecha, with holiness. Who tried to make something holy unholy? That was Yavan. Yavan took the shmanim, took the oil, and made them tameh. That was, again, symbolized to the Torah, to the ideas, to the wisdom that the Evanim tried to make impure. So that is the last thing that we say. Chasov zroa kochecha. Karev ketza Yeshua. Yeshua is redemption. Redemption, just like Bavel was taking at us of Galut and enslaving us, HaKadosh Baruch Hu would take us out and redeem us. And redeem us, and that's what it says. Chasov zroa kochecha v'karev ketz Yeshua nekom nikmat dam avadecha. That is symbolizes what Haman did in Malchut Paras, that tried to completely destroy us, and for that we need over here to be saved. And therefore, all of that is Umah Resha. Everything is mentioned in that Umah of Edom that's responsible for all that and more. And that's why it says over here, Ki archa lanu Yeshua ven ketz limei hara. The lengthy galut would not end until you have over here and ketz limei hara, the worst of all, and that is Ishmael. And ketz, in the end of day, that you don't see the end, it would be from the worst of the worst, that is yemei hara that we are experiencing right now. Comes the Zohar and says, you should know that the end of days, there's going to be over here all the Europeans getting together with the Ishmaelim, and a certain country will come from the end of the world. That could be that we're talking about North Korea, could be we're talking even about America, that will come to save from the end of the world, from the other side of the world, and come to save and come to make a fight with all of them for the purpose of eventually being bringing out the Mashiach will come out of that, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu himself would bring him, the Mashiach, down and would be mekayem the nevuah of Beita, that the time would come in the end of time, that although we don't see the end of the Galut, but with one little stone, just like we saw in the Hashmonaim, with one little pach shemen, they put the light over there and it continued, and that flame eventually was the Or Gadol that we celebrate until today. Chag Chanukah Sameach.